All right, Shalom, all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahawashai, Bahashem Kakodash, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone for teaching and ruling well in the scriptures, salutations to Yahakim across the world, pushing his word in truth and in sincerity with charity. And this is just going to be another quick lesson, all right, through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem Yahawashai. All right, as we go deeper and deeper into the latter days, the Lord has really been working on this place. The Lord is starting to it's starting to be evident that a higher power is making all these things happen on the planet, man. Okay, because what the Lord spoke of these things from the beginning. Okay, let me see if I can find it. This is I'm going to read two here. This is Isaiah 48, verse 3. This is Isaiah 48, verse 3. I have declared the former things from the beginning, and they went forth out of my mouth. It tells you that same sentiment in Isaiah, the 55th chapter, in the 11th verse. And I showed them, and I did them suddenly, and they came to pass. That's what we're experiencing. All right, so the world, what, through the prophets of Yahweh Shem Yahshai, the Lord is telling the world, all right, of his things that are to come, and they're coming to pass. All right, all these things spoken in the past, us going into captivity. All right, the chariots leading us through the Red Sea. All these things came to pass. All right, it's not going to be any different for these last days, where it talks about many great miseries are going to come upon these people. The mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip or the NFC chip, all right? Troops coming suddenly upon America. All these things are written, and they shall come to pass, just like everything else the Lord speaks, man. Okay? It says, this is Isaiah 48 and 5. I have even from the beginning declared it to thee, all right? Before it came to pass, I showed it thee, lest thou shouldst say, mine idol have done them. And my graven image and my molten image have commanded them. So this is not the work of any of these idols, Jesus Christ, Buddha. All right. This is the result. All right. And these are the works of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. You see? We can't blame anything on this, because these people of this world, they like to say Mother Nature and, you know, things of that nature. This is the doings of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Period. Okay, let's go to Isaiah 55. Isaiah 55 and 11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please. And it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. These prophecies, all right, all the prophecies of calamity and destruction and salvation are coming. All right, the Lord said he will take the mirth out of Babylon the Great. That's what we're seeing. All right. All these things are coming to pass, as Yahweh Bashem Yahushai stated. These are the tokens to let us know what's going down, that the Lord is near. All right. And how is he revealing it to us? Through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, through his spirit. Let's go to 2 Ezra 8. See if I can find it. This is 2 Ezra 8 and 47. 46. It says, then answered he me and said, things present are for the present, and things to come for such as be to come. Okay? This understanding was prepared to be given, all right, in these last days to certain spirits, man. To certain vessels, starting with the apostles and elders on down, man. You see? Never, and the Lord never gave this to the unrighteous, which is why you have your scoffers, which is why you have your gainsayers, demons. All right? Because the Lord is not drawing nigh to these people through the Spirit. He has not given them the eyes to see what's going on. They're of this world. All they can see, they can't see past this world. In order to see past this world, you have to be given the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, who is not of this world. You see? 2 Esdras chapter 8, verse 46. Then answered he me and said, things present are for the present, and things to come for such as be to come. For thou comest far short that thou shouldest be able to love my creature more than I. So this is telling us that stop worrying about to two-thirds. All right? Like the apostle said, they can't get it, we moving on, man. Especially in this time, man. We don't have time to be breaking our neck, breaking this down. There's all types of videos online, man. You coming on the comment boards, like the brother said, when you can just make a simple Google search. That's all you have to do. You know, we're in that time. You got to learn. We got to all learn. And we have to all study to show ourselves approved before Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Us, first and foremost, in the truth, teaching the truth. Okay? So we're all working out our own salvation with fear and trembling because of what? The Lord has given us the eye salve, right, to see that it's time to prepare ourselves for the great return of Yahweh Shai, his son, our Lord and Savior. All right? He's making good on that work that's being brought forth as he spoke it. He spoke the word, which is his son. Therefore, his son is going to come in these last days. All right? To the astonishment of what? Of the land, of America, Babylon, and Great, of the world, of these different nations, because the Lord is going to take over the planet. And we've been given foresight to see, all right, before his arrival. 2 Esdras 8, which means that we have a very good chance of being the elect. That's why we call ourselves the hopeful elect of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. 2 Esdras 8:46. Then answered he me and said, things present are for the present, and things to come for such as be to come. For thou comest far short that thou shouldest be able to love my creature more than I. But I have oftentimes drawn nigh unto thee and unto it, but never to the right to the unrighteous. In this also thou art marvelous before the Most High, in that thou hast humbled thyself as it becometh thee, and hast not judged thyself worthy to be much glorified among the righteous, man. This is a marvelous thing that's taking place, us coming and doing this, man, and pushing this word out. It's killing these people, man, because it's the truth, man. This is the truth of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. It shall be declared, what did it say, in the end. What did Isaiah, what did it say in Isaiah? The Lord is going to declare things from the beginning, all right, and it's going to come to pass. And we can't blame any idol or anything like that. Why? Because this is all the doing and orchestration of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. All right, 2 Esdras 8:48. In this also thou art marvelous before the Most High, and that thou hast humbled thyself as it becometh thee, and hast not judged thyself worthy to be much glorified among the righteous. For many great miseries shall be done to them that in the latter time shall dwell on the world. It's misery, many great miseries. Many great miseries are going to be done to these people, and we're seeing the Lord open up the can on these people, and it's nothing. The Lord hasn't even got started yet, man. All right, so there's a decline of American Babylon the Great, all right, due to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai's orchestration and his plan, man. There is no new world order of the elite banking families. This is the new world order of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. This is his footstool. This is his earth. Period, man. And that's why we're seeing these things play out, man. Okay? We have been given the foresight to see it, man. We have been given the foresight and the secrets through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Call all Yahweh Bashem Yahushai to see these things, man, and to prepare for the coming of the Lord Yahweh Shai, man. 2 Esdras 8:51. But understand thou for thyself, and seek out the glory for such as be like thee. For unto you is paradise open, the tree of life is planted, the time to come is prepared, plenteousness is made ready, a city is builded, and rest is allowed. Yeah, perfect goodness and wisdom, man. That's this truth, man. That's this understanding, this foresight, the eyesight we've been given, man. And it's going to culminate, and it's going to usher us into a kingdom. Lord willing, we are the elect. All right? The new world, the new dominion being ruled by Yahweh Shai, man. in complete righteousness, man. This is why they're seeing the chariots. This is what I've seen chariots. Brother have seen chariots. Chariots have came to camps of who? The men teaching this doctrine, the men teaching this beautiful truth. Like the brother Kowalya says here in Chicago, man. Chicago, man, this beautiful gospel. 2 Ezra 8 and 53. The root of evil is sealed up from you. Weakness and the moth is hid from you. And corruption is fled into hell to be forgotten. Sorrows are past, and in the end is showed the treasure of immortality. That's this truth. We've been given the gift to see what is going to be given to them who love Yahweh Bashem Yahshai at his appearing. Like the scripture says, man. 2 Ezra 8:54. Sorrows are past, and in the end is showed the treasures of immortality. And therefore ask thou no more questions concerning the multitude of them that perish. Don't be concerned with these people, man. We have to get deeper and deeper and more connected with Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, man. To myself first and foremost. Because the Lord is about to tear this place up, man. Alright. 2 Ezra 8. All types of things is gonna get bugged out. You have this Kamala Harris, Biden inauguration. The brothers have went into that. How that inauguration goes back to witchcraft. See? So heavy witchcraft is going to be done. All right. Heavy witchcraft, wickedness, and debauchery is going to be seen and shown out here. Crazy times are going to be brought to the forefront out here before the coming of the Lord. And we have been given the foresight. All right. That's going to help us get through it, man. Okay. Isaiah the 33rd chapter says, and the 6th verse says, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and strength of salvation. Alright, 2 Ezra 8 and 54. Sorrows are past, and in the end is showed the treasure of immortality. And therefore ask thou no more questions concerning the multitude of them that perish. For when they had taken liberty, they despised the Most High, thought scorn of his law, and forsook his ways. So people are scoffing against the men of the Lord. They try to demonize us. All right, put us on the news, all these things, man. Okay, because what? This knowledge has been locked and sealed away from them. Like it tells you in Isaiah the 6th chapter that 2/3 of our people are never going to get this truth all the way into their destruction, man. So it's a blessing that you're able to see and comprehend, and this resonates with your spirit. You see what the prophets are saying when they paint the visions, all right, by way of their speakings, by way of their prophesying, man. Okay. As for the other people, 2 Ezra 8 and 56, for when they had taken liberty, they despised the Most High, thought scorn of his law, and forsook his ways. Moreover, they have trodden down the righteous and said in their heart that there is no God. So that is really the sentiment of these people. If they're not in this truth and they're talking about God, and you know, it's not some people, you know, they might just be lost, and they might be of the 1/3. Who knows? They might wake up. The Lord might wake them, put a spirit on them to understand. But ultimately, these Christians, these pastors in the church, these fake Christians, these Lutherans, you know, because I had a Lutheran man, client, all right, so to speak, and this man said, I'm Lutheran, but I'm bisexual. And I went to school to be a pastor. Complete madness. These people do not believe in the Bible. These people are liars in this society. These people are ungodly. And that's the sentiment of an American, man. You see? Second Ezra 8. What was I? Second Ezra 8 and 56. For when they had taken liberty, they despised the Most High, thought scorn of his law, and forsook his ways. I'm a bisexual. The scripture says that shouldn't be. It tells you the law, and it tells you about that in the law, in Leviticus. It tells you about that in Romans, the 1st chapter. These things should not be. So this man went out of his way to do whatever he wanted to do. All right. He went after his own ways. That's the sentiment of an American, a Babylonian. A person the Lord does not draw nigh unto. The Lord, a person who the Lord darkens. You see? A person who the Lord hides from light. Because they go after their own ways and forsake the ways of the Lord. And they read this in the scriptures. But they go after their own ways and forsake the ways of the Lord, which is to do contrary to what he's doing. 2 Esdras 8. 2 Esdras 8:56. For when they had taken liberty, they despised the Most High, thought scorn of his law, and forsook his ways. Moreover, they have trodden down his righteous, and said in their heart that there is no power, there is no God. Yeah, and that knowing they must die. And that's what the scripture says, and that's what the Lord is coming to do, to render judgment. All right? The Lord is going to return and show the earth there is a higher government than what they have, than what that has been hid from them, man. There is another government, all right, past Esau, because the world is in a state of mind thinking that Esau, the so-called white man, is the God, is the upright nation of the people of the world, man. You see? These are the things that the world is about to experience, man. Complete and utter righteousness coming back with power, man. And starting with this word and this understanding from the apostles and elders on down. To all the other people that don't understand, it's going to mean death and destruction and judgment. 2 Esdras 8:58, and said in their heart that there is no power, yeah, and that knowing they must die. For as the things aforesaid, these are the words of the Most High. You people are not dealing with us. You're dealing with the power that created the reality, me and you scoffers, us and us brothers from the apostles and elders on down, and you scoffers and people that don't believe. The same reality we wake up into. This is the God we are telling you that is saying these things, man. You see? You really get mad at us because you hate him and his words and his ways, and you forsake them, man. 2 Esdras 8:59. For as the things aforesaid shall receive you, all right, which is talking to the believers, the things, the promises, the covenant, the glorious kingdom, righteousness, salvation. That's what's going to be for people that believe in this word and continue in it, from the apostles and elders on down. That's the elect, which we hope to be, the innumerable multitude, the remnant. Those are things that are going to be received. Those things that are going to be the reward to those people, believers. All right, this is what's going to be for unbelievers. So thirst and pain are prepared for them, the people that walk after their own way, that have went after their own ways and forsook the Lord. It says, for it was not his will that men should come to naught. The Most High didn't want to do this to 2/3 of our people, but they chose to forsake the Most High. So he can't save you. If you're not following instructions, you're not repenting, all right, you're not coming out of this place spiritually before we actually come out of this place physically, you're not trying, all right? And those are the people you see that want Biden and Harris in office, man. Those are the people you see that want black excellence, black culture to continue, man. You see? The Lord has much great miseries to prepare for you. It says, I'm going to read it again, 2 Esdras 8:59. For as the things aforesaid shall receive you, so thirst and pain are prepared for them, for it was not his will that men should come to naught. But they which be created, the creation. That's why it tells you that a lot of these people serve the creation more than the creator, Yahweh. We are the creation, man. And we are the creation serving the creation instead of the creator, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. 2 Esdras 8:60. But they which be created, Slakia 59, for as things aforesaid shall receive you, so thirst and pain are prepared for them. For it was not his will that men should come to naught. But they which be created have defiled the name of him that made them, and were unthankful. You see us out there freezing in the cold, standing week in and week out, pushing lessons out every day. But it shows you that our people are unthankful of the things that the Lord has promised to them in these last days, man. And what do you think? What do you do to someone that's unthankful? You don't deal with them. Your efforts are obviously not enough for them to be thankful. So the Lord, just basically 2/3 of our people, the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahushua, is not good enough for them, man. His grace is not sufficient for them, man. The Lord could have this captivity been worse for us. Man, 2 Esdras 8 Second Exodus 8 and 60. But they which be created have defiled the name of him that made them, and were unthankful unto him which prepared life for them. And man, and therefore is my judgment now at hand. And that's the times we're living in now, man. Alright. We are living in those times where the Lord is going to begin to draw nigh to the earth. Okay. Bear with me one second. I know there's a scripture that I was looking for. This is 1 Peter 4. As you can see it here. 1 Peter chapter 4. First Peter 4 and 6. For this cause was the gospel preached also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to men in the flesh, but living according to the Most High in the Spirit. But the end of all things is at hand. Be therefore sober and watch unto prayer. You see? We are in that time, man. Let's get another scripture. Speaking on that time at hand. This is Revelation chapter 1. This is a good one. Revelation chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed is he that readeth. And when you go into that Greek word for readeth, it means understandeth what you're reading. Which a lot of these other Israelite camps don't do. They read the scriptures, but they're not really reading the scriptures, because they would have known that that word readeth actually has a deeper meaning than what is seen. This is because they don't study to show themselves approved. But that's another lesson. Verse 3, blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. We have to continue to teach his word. People coming into the truth, continue to wash yourself, repent, be prepared, all right, our minds for these things we're about to go through, because of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai and the testimony, because we have the truth, man. We have the truth of this reality, and we are actually above the elite, man. You see, the prophets, starting from the apostles and elders on down to all the brothers around the world, are above the wicked elite, man, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai. And they're mad. All right. But it's prophecy. It says this truth shall be declared in the last days. And that's what's taking place, man. Revelations 1 and 3. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand, man. The time is at hand for judgment. The time is at hand for the Lord's coming and the redemption of Israel, man. The end of our captivity, man. Let's go to Revelation 22. And this is just through the Spirit. The Spirit is like the wind. Revelation 22 and... Revelation 22 and 7. This is our Lord and Savior. That... it's coming with the heavenly host. They're seeing the chariots. They disclassified the so-called UFOs, which are the chariots of Israel. Revelations 22 and 7. Behold, this is the Lord. I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. And I, John, saw these things and heard them. And when I had heard and seen, I fell down to worship before the feet of the angel which showed me these things. Then saith he unto me, see thou do it not, for I am thy fellow servant, and of thy brethren the prophets, and of them which keep the sayings of this book. Worship Yahweh, Bashem Yahushai. And he saith unto me, seal not the sayings of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. We have to teach his word continuously, you know, to the best of our ability. We have to do our, the apostle has deemed, one video a day. And he said, you might miss a day. That's when you do more videos the next day. You know? And just really stand and, Paul said, give attention to reading, man. You know, and that's very important, man, because this is all we have, man. And it's killing these people, man, because it's through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And it's bringing this place to naught, man. This reality has changed so fast, man. All right? Because the Lord's going to make a quick work of this place, man. Revelations 22. And 11, he that is unjust, let him be unjust still. And he which is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still, man. And that's us in this truth, man. Because the Lord has separated us through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shemiah Shai. He has separated us and has drawn near to us, like it tells you in 2 Ezra, and never to the unrighteous, man. That's why the Lord said, hold that fast which thou hast. All right? Because this is what we have, this truth, the understanding, the faith. Revelations 22 and 12, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according as his work shall be. Okay? And the Lord is not like Esau. The Lord is going to, he didn't forget our labor of love, as it says in the scriptures, man, roughly paraphrasing. All right? And the husbandman or the laborer is worth his hire. Okay? So we're going to get paid something for whatever it is from Yahweh Shemiah Shah, a higher entity than this, than what these people imagine and what we have seen in this reality, man. Our Lord and Savior, man. Revelations 22 and 13, I am Alpha and Omega. That means the beginning and the end. The beginning and the end, the first and the last. All right? This is what we have been given the spirit to understand. We are, Lord willing, we're all those men, women, and children returning to get saved. All right? We are the blessed of Yahweh Shemiah Shai, man. All right? Let me get another scripture. That's the spirit. This is Matthew's 13. Matthew 13, 16. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For verily I say unto you, that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which ye see, which we're seeing now, and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear, and have not heard them. Okay? This is what we've been. We are blessed, man, to have this understanding, man. And on the contrary, the wicked of our people in the world are cursed and condemned already because they believe not this truth and this gospel, man. Okay? All right, so Lord willing, that was edifying. We got to continue into what we're doing. All right? Satan's out here. We got to pray more, fast more to our best of our ability. All right? And continue on, man. And enduring to the end like the scripture says, man. Lord willing, that was edifying. Call halal yimlai yahweh ba hashem yahweh shai ba hashem rakak wadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone for teaching and ruling well in the scripture. Salutations to you, Akim, across the world, pushing his word and truth and his sincerity and with charity. Shalom and abba ba ball.